Saving your work frequently is important in case PowerPoint or your computer shuts down unexpectedly. But there's more than one way to save in PowerPoint 2010. We'll look at the Save As option first, which lets you choose a name and location for your file. Just click File, Save As, then enter a file name, and save. This is perfect if you need to save a presentation for the first time, or as in this case, you're saving a different version of something you've been working on. Once you've done that step, you can switch to using the regular save command on your quick access toolbar. This is just a convenient way to continue saving your presentation in its current location using the same file name. If you forget to save or unexpectedly lose your work, not to worry. PowerPoint's AutoRecover feature automatically saves a copy while you're working every 10 minutes. To check for auto-saved versions, open a presentation that was previously closed without saving. Now go to the Backstage view and look under Info. Auto-saved versions will be listed here. Just click to open, then Restore, and OK to save and keep it. Now I'd like to show you how to save files that'll work with previous versions of PowerPoint. You'll need to use a different file format called PowerPoint 97 to 2003 to share with anyone who uses PowerPoint 2003 or earlier. Just click the File tab, then Save As, and in the Save As Type drop-down menu, choose PowerPoint 97 to 2003 Presentation. Now edit the file name or location if you need to, then save. Because some of the current features in PowerPoint 2010 aren't supported by earlier versions, you may get a notice about your presentation's compatibility. Click Continue to save in the 97 to 2003 format anyway. Finally, if you ever need to send your presentation to someone who doesn't have PowerPoint at all, you can choose a completely different format in the Backstage view under Save and Send. Alternatives include creating a PDF or XPS document, which will save your presentation as a document instead of a slideshow. You can also create a video of your presentation to share online or in an email, or package the contents for a CD. This option puts your presentation in a folder along with a special PowerPoint viewer that anyone can download and use. Now you know several different ways to save and make your presentation compatible for sharing.
Like what you just saw?
Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.